Mr. Brad, our after-school activity coordinator, for setting up all the after-school activities. And this is just one of them. This isn't a regular grade assembly. This is an after-school activity assembly. We'd like to show you a play. It's based on a book. The original book was Tom Sawyer. Tom Sawyer was written by Mark Twain. We're going to change it a little bit and make it a Thai version. It's going to be POM Sawyer. POM Sawyer is a naughty little boy who gets into trouble, but he's also very clever because he knows how to get out of work. He gets his friends to do his work for him. So you have to listen and see how he does that. Maybe you can get your friends to do that for you too. Okay? All right. The actors are from grade 3 and grade 4. And it would have been nice to have a couple of more practices, but our time has run out, so we're going to go to get on with the show very quickly. I think everybody's ready. All right. POM Sawyer. Thank you.
Hey, narrators, you're on.
Once upon a time, a girl named POM Sawyer grew up poorly in Missouri town on the Mississippi River.
Like many other 9 and 10-year-old girls, POM got into her share of mischief.
It's supper time, Pop, and if you're hungry again, you best come out, or you'll be going to bed hungry tonight.
Pom younger Sydney Pond told her aunt.
Aunt Polly, I haven't seen Pom any time after lunch.
That girl played tricks long enough for me looking out for them, but she never played alike in 2 days in a row. How's a person supposed to know what's coming next?
Pick a bell a day. Oh, Lordy,
Piccabella day.
Oh, glory, Piccabella autumn. Oh, glory, Piccabella day. Oh, glory, Piccabella cotton. Oh, glory, Piccabella day.
Oh, no, it's late. I better go home or I'm going to kill you.
Pom can't wait.
Pom came running in for supper in the nick of time, suspecting that she skipped school that afternoon. Aunt Polly questioned her at the supper table.
Warm day in school, was it, Pom?
Yes, ma'am.
Very, very warm, was it?
Yes, ma'am, it surely was.
Pom heard Aunt Polly talking to her, but she saw that she was looking directly at her hair the whole time.
Didn't you want to go swimming, Pom?
By now, Pom knew that Aunt Polly was fishing for something, and she kind of knew what her questions were leading up to. She decided she better try to throw her off track.
Some of us pump water on our heads. See? Mine's still damp.
Oh, I see. I also see that your shirt collar is dry. Tell me, Pom, how do you keep your shirt collar dry from splashing into the water?
I guess I might folded my collar for sometime.
She played hooky, Aunt Polly.
You played hooky, Paul. Sit upon you, snitch. I will get you for that.
You'll do no such thing. I thank my lucky stars, Serpa is a quiet girl with such adventuresome ways.
It pains me, Pop, but I'm forced to make you work tomorrow.
But tomorrow's Saturday.
It's like you have your Saturday today, Pop.
Grabbing her by the ear.
The fence outside is sorely in need of whitewashing. Don't think you'll be only doing half of the job. I'll be coming by to inspect it.
That whole fence?
Every last speck of it. No streaks, you hear?
Not one or I'll tell Aunt Polly on you.
But there isn't any whitewash paint.
Oh, yes, there is. I mixed 2 pails of it this morning. And I'll tell the other kids that you can't go swimming, because you gotta go whitewash. Bye now.
As Pom trod down the sidewalk with her bucket and brush, a dark gloom came over her normally happy spirits. On such a day, a kid would be swimming, fishing, flying a kite or rope housing.
There must be 30 meter of fence here and 2 meters higher to the millimeter. It'll be nightfall before...
What you got there, Pom?
It's whitewashing. I see you're carrying a tin pail. Going to fetch some water?
Just like every Saturday morning, Pom.
Say, Jane, I'll fetch the water for you if you like to whitewash for a while.
Can't, Pom. Your Aunt Polly said you might ask. She told me to tend my own business.
Oh, never mind what she says, Jane. Come on, give me that pail. I'll only be gone a minute.
Who are you trying to kid, Pom? Your Aunt Polly will tear my head off. No, thanks. I'll fetch my own water and you can do your own whitewash.
Jan walked away with Pom yelling after him.
Go on then, Jane. Too bad, though. I got a yo-yo I was going to give you. Besides, but too bad, though. You can just go and... Golly! Here comes that little dark-eyed boy with the black hair I saw in Sunday church. Golly, golly! It wouldn't do him long to see me toiling away on this fine summer day.
Suddenly inspired, Pom picked up the brush, dipped it into the white wash, and pinned a long white strip down one of the planks, top to bottom. Then she stepped back to admire her work, moving directly into the boy path as he came walking by.
Oh, pardon me, sir. I was so absorbed in this here. Art that say, do I know you?
I'm Bobby Thatcher. I live down the street.
Yeah, I don't recall seeing you around here before.
We moved in the week before last. What's your name?
I'm Pom Sawyer. True ways to get better acquainted of you. But as you can see, I'm what you call preoccupied right now.
It looks like all you're doing is paying an offense.
Just as Pom was about to protest, she caught sight of Pam Roger, Pom deep in the brush, and gave it a good sweep across several plants.
You have work today, Pom.
Why, hello, Pam. I didn't notice you come along.
I'm going swimming, Pom. Don't you wish you could? Sure you would. You rather would.
What are you calling work?
But Rush is work.
Pom calls it art.
Who asked you? Matter of fact, who are you?
I'm Bobby Thatcher, and you needed to speak to me in that tone.
No tone about it, Buster. And whitewash is work. Pure and simple.
Well, maybe it is and maybe it isn't, but all know that it suits Pom, so you're just fine.
Pom continued dipping and brushing with a forage. Bobby noticed that Pom's brush stroke had crudely formed the letter B inside a shape that almost looked like half of a heart. Bobby blushed and covered his face with his book. Pen took a big bite of the apple she was holding.
Is that supposed to be Bobby? You must go back to school and learn more spelling. You mean you like doing this, Pom?
Why wouldn't I? It's not an everyday body gets a chance to whitewash.
Why don't you let me whitewash a while?
No, I don't know, Pen. That just wouldn't do. Aunt Polly's real particular about this fence.
Is that so?
Well, if it was a back fence, she wouldn't mind. But with the fence being right out on the street and all, well, you have to do it real careful. Not one kid in 1,000, maybe 2,000 can do it the way it has to be done.
Come on now, Pom. Just only a little. If I were you, I would let you whitewash.
Oh, Pen. I'd like to. Honest, but I'm Polly. Well, Sir Pom wanted to do it. And then Jane. But she won't let either of them. You see the spot I'm in? Well, if anything went wrong,
sure, Pom. Only a little. I will be as careful